gotta work to do. Pass me the paint and glue. Perfect isn't easy, but it's me.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So this is gonna be a get ready with me video because I'm not going to work. Because I work for an events company and you can't have events over 50 people now, we don't have work to do. So I'm at home making videos because I'm bored. So yeah, get ready with me.
Woohoo!
Obviously I just got out of the shower, so my hair's wet and wavy. But so because I just got out of the shower, what I'm gonna do is put in my Noodlehead leave-in conditioner. And then I'll put my hair in a towel. Even though some people think you're not supposed to do that, but it's fine. Just let me do myself, okay? Frick. So yeah. Crazy weather we're having. Now I'm just gonna do the rest of my routine while I let the conditioner soak into the hair. I really like have this thing about people watching me brush my teeth, so I'm not gonna let you see this part. I like to swish with hydrogen peroxide as like my mouthwash because I feel like it actually cleans better and it like whitens my teeth a little bit. Just a personal preference, but you do you. I'll do me. So for my face wash, I am currently using, in the mornings, I use this Beyond Belief, their pore purifying system. And I got this all at Sally's. Like, I have, like it's ridiculous. I'm gonna get my face wet, and I'm gonna use this facial foaming cleanser, and then I'm gonna do the pore purifying facial scrub. So I don't exfoliate every day because it's not good for your skin, so I only use this, the scrub that exfoliates, I only use that about every 2 or 3 days. After my face is all nice and washed and exfoliated, I take this. This is Skin Renewing Witch Hazel by Beyond Belief. And I've read some stuff saying that the witch hazel can actually help with acne scarring. But because I have dry skin, I have to be a little bit careful because it does have alcohol in it, which can dry your skin out and that cause some damage. So I put some extra vitamin E on afterwards, and I'll show you guys that. Because the witch hazel has alcohol in it, I do add these hydrating booster drops. You guys have seen these in my other videos before. And it's like just like a blast of vitamin E all over my face so that I don't get dried out or damaged from the alcohol in the witch hazel. After the vitamin E, I put on my actual moisturizer from Beyond Belief. And I just got all of this from Sally Beauty, like this whole Beyond Belief system, and I like it for the morning. If you've seen my other video, you know I use Rodan and Fields at night to take care of my skin. But in the morning, I love Beyond Belief, so. And then I finish off my skincare with this retinol facial mist. And it's just like a hydrating facial mist, so. I'm gonna squirt this on a couple times. Let's jump into hair. So my hair's been sitting in this towel, just soaking up the conditioner. Make sure the water's squeezed out of it. Today I don't want to use any heat on my hair, and I've been trying not to damage it, so I'm just gonna go with the natural curly look. So I'm just gonna use this, I'm gonna start with this curl boosting spray, and I'm gonna spray it all over. Now I have a lot of hair. Like, each hair is really thin and really fine, but I have a lot of it, so I use a lot of product. So you probably don't need to use quite as much if you have thinner hair. Next, I'm going to use this curl boosting glaze, the Noodlehead from Beyond the Zone.
Woohoo!
And again, I found all of this stuff at Sally's too, So, yay, Sally Beauty. So, yeah. So, I'm gonna squeeze it in. Those of you that have seen Frozen 2, like, it's on Disney Plus, highly recommend. It was a good watch. But, you know, like, Frozen 2, where Olaf is like, he's like singing that song, like, this will all make sense when I'm older. And then at the end of the song, he just kind of stands there, he's like, this is fine. And then he gets swept away by the tornado. Yeah, that's how I feel right now. You know, I'm just like, this is fine. So once my hair is all scrunched to death, I take my little diffuser hair and I start blow drying it. I won't make you watch this whole thing because it's loud and boring. So. Mostly dry. I'm just gonna go through, scrunch it one more time just to make sure like the glaze isn't crunchy or whatever. Not trying to have crunchy hair. There you have it. So I decided to come up to my front room and do my makeup in here because one, I don't have to stand. Like I'm literally sitting on the floor right now. And two, I have this beautiful view out my window of the mountains. And right now, it's the little things that count. Let's just be honest. I don't want like a heavy look today because I want my skin to be like open so we can relax because I wore a lot of makeup this past weekend because it was my birthday and yeah, all that stuff. So I'm not gonna put anything on my face. I'm just gonna jump in with this. The Rodin & Fields Recharge Protect and Blur Broad Spectrum SPF 30 sunscreen. And because it has a blurring effect, I've said this before, it's like a primer. So because I'm not wearing any makeup today, I'm just gonna put this on. Pretty much just gonna do my eyes and my eyebrows and my lips today. Anybody else excited for summer? Honestly, like I wanted to go longboarding this weekend, but it ended up being really windy here in Utah. So I was like, okay, I guess not, that's fine. That's okay, because I did have a good birthday weekend. Like, I went out and went bowling on Friday. Everyone who's afraid of the coronavirus just cringed a little, but I'm not dying. I'm not sick. I don't feel sick. I don't feel like I'm getting anything. I think I'm fine. And we also played pool that night. And I came home and watched Frozen and drank wine. And yeah, I don't even know what I'm doing right now. I think I'm gonna do eyebrows. On Saturday for my birthday, it was just kind of like a laid back day. My mom and I went and looked at my dress because we're making my veil for the wedding. So we went and made sure like all the beads that we have would match. What else did I do Saturday? I went dancing Saturday night at the West Center. That was really fun. Probably stayed up till like 2 or 3 Saturday night, which was like, actually, I think we stayed up till 5. Yeah, we totally did because we came home and we watched movies after dancing. We didn't get home from dancing until like 3. So yeah, we stayed up till like 5 o'clock in the morning Saturday night, which was kind of fun. We haven't done that in a while. And then it was my dad's birthday on Sunday, but he lives in Montana, so I sent him a text. And like usually Dave and I go to volleyball, or we're trying to go to volleyball Sunday mornings, but that did not happen considering we were up until 5 a.m. Okay, I'm gonna move on to the eyeshadow now that my eyebrows are done. Just going for like a nice nude look. Nothing too crazy, just to give some colors. My birthday is March 13th, which landed on a Friday this year. So you can imagine, like, I was like, what am I gonna do for my birthday? And I had all these plans, and then with like the coronavirus stuff, it kind of just like didn't really work out. But that's okay because I still ended up having a good time. A friend from work actually gave me this eyeshadow palette for my birthday, and I used it on my birthday when we went out for bowling and stuff. And I'm not gonna lie, I freaking love it. Like, what is this? It's the ColourPop Nude Mood. Like, I freaking love it actually. Like, it works really well and I like the colors and I like how it sits on my face. Makes me... It's like, at least my eyeshadow is still good, I think. I'm gonna do some eyeliner because I'm feeling edgy today. That is not eyeliner. I almost just put this on my eye. It's red lip liner. Hold on. Okay, now I have the eyeliner. Like, it's for real this time. We're good. So I'm 22 now, and I feel like there's like no more good birthdays to be had. You know what I mean? It's like 21, you can drink, so obviously you go out and drink. But after that, it's like, okay, yeah, I can drink now, but I don't want to. And it's like the only big like milestone after this is like 26, but that's when you have to, like, you get off your parents' health insurance, you have to get your own, like, what? And I also can't get this eyeliner open. Ugh! Why? Got it. I'm not going for a winged look, cause, well, maybe. Should I? Oh, I'll try it. Sure. Sure. Are these even? Probably not. This is as good as it's gonna get today. Just kinda wanna go do a photo shoot. Like, I think I'm gonna set up a photo shoot, like maybe a couple of photo shoots while I'm not working. It's like, I've got the time now, you know? Now would be a good time for them to release like Rick and Morty season 4. Like, you know how like they release like half of it? And then nothing? Be a really good time for that to happen. So quiet in here, you can hear the clock ticking in the background. Okay, let's do the lips. Which one should I use? I'm gonna use this one. All right, so this is brand new. I haven't used this yet. Hold on, freaking open it. So this is Elf Lip Plumping Gloss. Oh my goodness, I cannot talk. Whew, that is tingly. Okay. There it is. I am now done with my makeup for the day. All right, so with makeup all done, this is it. Just gotta get dressed. So, oh my gosh, should I do like that jumping transition? I don't know if that worked. We'll see. So yeah, so that's it with Get Ready With Me today. So, enjoy your weekend. Enjoy your night. Enjoy your morning. Whatever time you're watching this at, I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope that this coronavirus stuff blows over. And I hope that you and your families are all safe and healthy. And I love you guys. Bye.